turning your Bibles to the book of John. I'd like to read from John chapter 4. Word of God here tells us about Jesus and the woman at the well and the conversation that they had. I encourage you to go home and read beginning at the first verse in the book of John chapter 4. Read the entire chapter. Lots of good reading and understanding and many lessons that are found in that passage of scripture. I'm going to kind of go into the middle of that conversation in John chapter 4 and verse 19. I want to begin right there and let's go through verse 30. John chapter 4, beginning in verse 19, the Word of God says, "The woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah, that is the Messiah, cometh, which is called Christ." Now she's beginning to recognize and see clearly that this is Christ, and so she begins to hint at the possibility of him being Christ. She says in verse 25, "The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus saith unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. And upon this came his disciples and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, What seekest thou? Or why talkest thou with her?" Listen carefully now to verse 28. The Word of God says, "The woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city, and saith unto the men, Come, see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him." That is, they came unto Jesus. So the main thing that we want to look at tonight is the woman going out and telling other people about Jesus and saying that this is the Christ, or asking the question, is not this the Christ? And then those people go to Christ and they begin to see that indeed he is the Christ. So I want to talk about us telling others about Jesus. And there was something that this woman had to do or did before she went to talk to other people. The Word of God says in the beginning of verse 28, "The woman then left her water pot." That wasn't just a little pitcher. That was a water pot that supplied the livelihood, the life. Water was absolutely necessary. And water was not near as plentiful in her day as it is in our day. And so her water pot was extremely valuable to her and to her family and to all those that she was associated with. But she left her water pot. And then the Word of God says, "Then the woman left her water pot and went her way into the city and saith unto the people, unto the men, Come and see. Come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ?" She begins to tell them about Jesus. This woman left her water pot. And I believe that in all of our lives, that before we will ever be able to effectively tell each other and tell other people about Jesus, that we have to leave some things before we can ever really serve Christ effectively. And this woman left her water pot, but all of us have our own water pots. We all have our things that we have to leave in order for us to be able to tell others about Jesus. Now, leaving something can be all kinds of things. It can be material things. Sometimes we have to leave material things in order to go and tell others about Jesus. Certainly, material things cannot be the focus of our life. We have to leave them. We have to set them aside. We have to set our affections on things above and not on things of the earth. If you're going to set your affection on things above, then you have to leave those water pots. You have to leave those carnal things. You have to leave those material things. You have to love God more than you love anything in this world. All those water pots have to be left to serve Christ. Those water pots could also represent people. Sometimes, instead of material things separating us from our service to God, sometimes it's people. And sometimes we love the prestige of men, and we're afraid to talk to other people about Jesus because we don't want to lose the glory that we have among men. We don't want other people to think less of us than they might think. We want them to have us up on a pedestal. And if you talk to other people about Jesus, they might think that you have become a religious fanatic. So sometimes we're afraid to talk to other people about Jesus because we're afraid of what they might say about us, or we're afraid of what they might think about us. Well, we have to leave our water pots. That water pot could also be pride, is part of what we're talking about right now. You have to set that pride aside. You have to leave that pride if you're going to talk to other people about Jesus. You're also going to have to leave self-righteousness aside. You have to lay aside all that self-righteousness that you might feel in your life. You cannot serve Jesus effectively as long as you feel that you are righteous in and of your own self. If you feel like that you are good enough to be called a child of God, if you feel like that you have made enough sacrifices that God ought to appreciate what you're doing, then you are full of pride and arrogancy. And we need to pray that God will help us to leave those obstacles that interfere with us serving God. Go with me, if you will, back in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 4. Because all the way through the Word of God, this will be the only other example that we look at. But I do want you to look at one other example of people leaving their water pots. And it's not called water pots here, but it's leaving some things in order to be a follower of Jesus Christ, in order to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. Did you know that all 12 of the apostles, they all left very important things in their lives? The things that they left were just as important to them as that water pot was to the woman in John chapter 4. And yet, even though those things were important to them, they were willing to leave their water pots. And we need to be willing to leave our water pots so that we can go and talk to others about Jesus Christ. I want to encourage everybody here tonight. I want to encourage you to talk to somebody this week about Jesus. I want to encourage you to tell others about what Jesus has done for you and is doing for you in your life. And in order to do that, you're going to find out that you have to lay something aside in order for you to be able to talk to other people about Jesus. In Matthew chapter 4, beginning in verse 18, we read about Jesus beginning to call four of his disciples. He's calling them to be followers of him. In Matthew chapter 4, beginning in verse 18, "And Jesus, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brethren, Simon called Peter and Andrew his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers." That's the vocation, that's the occupation that several of the disciples had, is that they were fishermen. Verse 19 says, "And he saith unto them," he said to those two men, Simon called Peter and Andrew his brother, who were fishing, he said unto them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." Verse 20, the Word of God says, and they straightway left their nets. They left what? They left their nets. Now what did the woman at the well leave? She left her water pots and went and began to tell those men about Jesus. Now, Andrew and Peter are going to leave their nets, and the purpose of them leaving their nets is to follow Jesus and then to go and tell other people about Jesus Christ, about how great he is and about what he has done for them and that he is the Messiah. And so Peter and Andrew left their nets. And then verse 21 says, and going on from thence, he saw other two brethren, James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, in a ship with Zebedee, their father, mending their nets, and he called them. And they immediately, listen carefully, and they immediately left the ship and their father and followed him. So in those two examples that we have right here in Matthew chapter 4, the Word of God says that Peter and Andrew left their nets. And then it tells us that James and John left their ship. Do you think that ship was important to James and John? And then it also says that they left their father Zebedee. All examples that we're mentioning are people that had to give up great things in order to follow Jesus Christ. And in following Christ, they saw how great Christ was. And Christ provided everything they needed. And they talked to other people and preached to other people about the greatness of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I just want to remind everybody here, if you're going to follow Jesus, if you're going to be a faithful disciple of Jesus, you're going to have to leave your water pots. You're going to have to leave your nets. You're going to have to leave your ship. You're going to have to leave your father or mother or brother or sister. You're going to have to leave other things and people sometimes in order to follow Jesus Christ. Now, after Peter began to follow Jesus, he began to think about all those things that he had left, and he went to Jesus on one occasion and talked to Jesus and said, in essence, he was saying, Jesus, look at what all we have left. Go with me in your Bibles to Luke chapter 18. I want you to hear the words of Peter when Peter begins to talk to Jesus about, we've left everything to follow you. We've left our nets, we've left our ships, we've left our family to follow you. Now what are we going to get for that? Watch what Jesus says as they're talking to Jesus and telling Jesus about what they've left. Did Jesus already know everything they had left? Was he touched with their dedication and their commitment? Was he pleased with their lives? Was he pleased with the sacrifices they were making to follow him? Indeed, they were. And Peter was already being blessed, but he didn't comprehend how much he was being blessed. I want to say to everybody here tonight, you made a sacrifice by being in the house of God tonight. All of you had to leave something to come to the house of God tonight. And I am very thankful that I have the privilege of trying to serve a people that love Jesus and want to do everything they can to manifest that love to Jesus. But don't ever get like Peter is right here, where Peter begins to think like Jesus owed him something, because Jesus doesn't owe us anything. But he is a rewarder of those that leave their water pots and their nets and their ship and their family. He does reward and bless our lives as we leave those things to be a follower of Jesus Christ. Look what he says now in Luke chapter 18, beginning in verse 28. Luke 18, beginning in verse 28. The Word of God says, then Peter said, lo, we have, what are the next two words?
Left all.
Now, we only read about them leaving, as far as Peter is concerned. The only thing the Scripture told us about that they had left was they left their nets, as far as Peter is concerned. But Peter, when he left those nets and began to follow Jesus, he was leaving everything. Even though the only thing that's spelled out there is his nets. He was laying aside everything else in his life so that he could follow Jesus Christ. And that's the kind of commitment that we need in our lives. And I'm not talking about you just going out to be a preacher that you have to leave everything. You know, Sister Doris, this morning we were studying about the home and how wonderful the home is, and that we don't need to be leaving the home, and we need to stay in our home. And after church was over, in the back, she said, "You need to preach tonight about sometimes God calls you to leave your home and go off and preach somewhere else." And you understand the burden? Well, you know, they had to leave their water pots when they were called to Love's Chapel Church. They had to leave their house. They sold their house. They had to leave those people. They had to leave that families that they had right there. They had to leave this church family. And I don't think anything hurt them anymore. I don't think there was anything they left that hurt them any more than leaving this church. But I'll tell you, brethren, God's going to bless that family because they left things that were very important to them to go where God would have them to be. You and I, as the people of God, we need to be willing to leave all. We must leave all. If we're not willing to leave all, then we can't be a disciple of Christ. So Peter says here, Lord, we've left all and followed thee. Verse 29, and he said unto them, that's Jesus said unto them, verily I say unto you, there is no man that hath left houses, that hath left house, or parents, or brethren, or wife, or children, for the kingdom of God's sake, who shall not receive manifold more in this present time, and in the world to come, life everlasting. I'll tell you, brethren, there are great blessings to those that leave all and follow Jesus. These individuals, they were living in a Jewish world, and Peter was asking Jesus, Lord, do you see what all we've left? We've left it all to follow thee. And he says, there's nobody that's left all those things for the kingdom of God's sake who shall not receive manifold more in this present time. That is, in that Jewish world that they were already in. And then he says, and in the world to come. This is the world that Jesus speaks about in Matthew chapters 24 and 25. The world to come came after the destruction of Jerusalem. That was the world called the kingdom of heaven or the kingdom of God. And in the world to come, everlasting life. Brethren, there are great blessings that come to the people of God that are willing to leave all and follow him. Now go with me in your Bibles back to Matthew chapter 10. Because I do want you to see that as he's taught here in Luke chapter 18 and verse 29, he's talking about having to leave mother or father and houses and things like that. If you'll back up to Matthew chapter 10, now I want everybody to listen carefully because this is a little difficult to follow. Why were they leaving all? Now I know they were leaving all to follow Christ. But after they began to follow Christ, there was something else they were doing. They weren't just following Christ and eating at the banqueting table. They weren't just following Christ and seeing his miracles. They were following Christ, but then they began to tell others about Jesus. And that was where many of his disciples turned back and walked no more with him because they were not willing. They were willing to follow Jesus as long as they got food. They were willing to follow Jesus and see the miracles. They were willing to follow Jesus for many other reasons. But when it came to them beginning to tell others about Jesus, they withdrew, they held back. They didn't want other people to hear them putting their neck on the line and them begin to declare Jesus Christ. It's necessary for you to leave all if you're going to be a disciple of Jesus who tells others about Jesus. Now watch this carefully. Matthew 10, verse 32. Matthew 10, 32. Whosoever therefore, Matthew 10, 32. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. Now what is Jesus talking about doing here? When he says that whosoever confesses me before men. What's he talking about? He's talking about telling others about Jesus, telling them that he is the Christ, that he is the Messiah, that he is our Savior, that he is the creator of heaven and earth, that Jesus is the Son of God, and Jesus is God manifest in the flesh. That you go and you tell others about Jesus, failing to witness about Jesus, failing to tell others about Jesus, is denying him before men. I'm going to repeat that one more time. You don't have to go out there and say, I don't believe in Jesus. You don't have to go out there and say, I'm not going to follow Jesus. But if you don't tell other people about Jesus, if you're not testifying about Jesus, if you're not talking about Jesus, then you're denying Christ before men. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever therefore shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. What's he talking about? He's talking about the fact that when you begin to tell other people about Jesus, when you stand up for truth and righteousness, when you begin to stand up for the truth that's set forth in the Word of God, there's going to be a division that takes place. And if you're not willing to experience that division, if you're not willing to take a stand that will cause you to prove your love is greater for Christ than it is for any other person, place, or thing on this earth. If you have anything that's more important than Christ, if you have something that's more important than Jesus, then you're going to be denying him before men, and he will deny you before the Father which is in heaven. So he says in verse 35, I am come to set a man at variance against his father and the daughter against her mother. Who came to cause this division? Who came to bring this sword? Jesus did. He says, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and a man's foes shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. That's what we're talking about when we talk about leaving our water pots. We're talking about laying aside anything and anybody that's more important than Jesus Christ. And then he says in verse 38, and he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. Listen carefully to verse 39. He that findeth his life shall lose it, and he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. Let me just say this in closing. Jesus makes this statement in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 24. Jesus says, no man can serve, fill in the next two words. No man can serve two masters. Now that woman at the well, her master before she came to know Jesus, her master, her life, her livelihood, everything about her life revolved around that what? The water pot. And so she left her water pot and went and told those men about Jesus. Peter and Andrew and James and John, their life revolved around being a fisherman and their families and their ships and their nets. But they had to prove that they loved Jesus more than they loved all of that vocation that they had been involved with. And so they left their nets. Brethren, if you are willing to follow Jesus, if you're willing to put him first in your life, Jesus will be well pleased with your life. And Jesus will say to you, not in the final resurrection, but he'll say this as you're living. He'll say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. On the other hand, if you see Jesus and you recognize you've got these other things that are more important in your life than Jesus is, and you're not willing to lay aside that water pot, then you're going to be looking back and longing for the things that you had before you heard about Jesus. And Jesus makes this statement in Luke 9:62. He says, no man having put his hand to the plow, that is when you start to follow Jesus, that's after you've laid aside the water pots and you're following Jesus. No man having put his hand to the plow and looking back. What is he looking back at? What's he looking back for? What would that woman at the well, what would she be looking back for? The water pots. Peter and Andrew and James and John, what could they have been looking back for? their nets and their fishing industry. In fact, after the resurrection of Jesus, there was an occasion where Peter said, you remember what he said that brought shame and reproach on Peter? I go a fishing. You know what he was doing? He was going back to his water pot. God is merciful and gracious to all of us. Because in all of our lives, we have our water pots, and we have our fishes, and we have our nets, and we have our people that we sometimes love more than we love Jesus. And we need to pray, God, help me. Help me today. Help me every day to leave our water pots. Help us to leave our nets and our ships. Help us to leave whoever and whatever is necessary so that we can go and be a disciple of Jesus and tell others about Jesus, is my prayer for Christ's sake.